couple of years, so I'm good. Mm-hmm. I'm good. I'm here to do a charity work for Jackie Lewis,
okay,
pastor for Middle Church that burned out. Mm-hmm. I'm here to raise money for her. We're going to do a show, not really a show, but a charity thing at Riverside Church, and the Reverend Michael Livingston is going to be there too, and I'm just here to help and do my thing. We'll have to go out.
And do the right thing.
Absolutely. Do the right thing, my new single, yeah.
What did that single mean to you, let's do the right thing?
You know, remember the last time I was here, mm-hmm, I said I would never go in the studio again.
I know.
I didn't want to. But Charles Wright, a profound, wonderful director, directed a Motown Story on Broadway and did a lot of things. He called me one night and said, I want you to write a song for a show, a TV show. So it didn't work out that way, but then I went back in the studio with my writing partner, Marcus Malone, mm-hmm, and we wrote the song. But it was about what was going on with the George Floyd passing and the black-on-black crime. I'm really sick of the black-on-black crime, and I feel like as a people, we just have to help ourselves.
Absolutely.
And not look for anyone else to help us.
I was going to ask you that, because in the song you say we are in this together. I was going to ask, who is the we?
We, black people.
The black people, okay.
Black people, okay. Yes, black people, absolutely. Yes.
It's a beautiful, nice, uplifting song, and it's such a simple message, right? Like, why is it so hard for people to just do the right thing?
Why is it so hard? Why are we crabs in a basket? Mm. Why do we not lift each other up? Why don't we? I don't know why.
I don't know, man, especially nowadays, because it seems like it's profitable to tear other black people down.
It's extremely profitable, but I find that people that do that, I have no respect for.
Absolutely.
If you tear somebody down, I have no respect for. If you throw somebody under the bus, I have no respect for you.
Especially when there's people that claim to be pro-black, but then, like, when you tune into, like, you know, whatever their platforms are, they're only going at other black people.
They're only going at other black people. And because they're scared, we have adopted the Caucasian way of living. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? We have adopted so we can get along and we feel that that is the right way. Mm-hmm. And it's not. I've never adopted to that. Never. Mm-hmm. And I will never.
Absolutely.
So what about Juneteenth now? We have a national holiday, Juneteenth. People have been pushing for this for a long time. How do you feel about that?
I feel that it's a slap in the face. I feel that we need to put money in our communities. I feel that he needs to stop them from trying to take our voters' rights away.
Word.
I feel like it's a slap in the face. It should have been done a long time ago. I'm not impressed.
George Floyd Policing Act still not passed.
Not passed.
You know.
The rest of the policemen are not in jail. Mm-hmm. They should have gotten the death penalty, as far as I'm concerned. They were murderers. And I feel like, see, I probably would have been shot if I had been there with George Floyd, because I would have tried to pull one of those police officers, especially the police officer that was on his neck. I would have tried to pull. I don't think people should stand around and film somebody getting murdered. Mm-hmm. I don't.
Oh, yeah, but people be scared. They be traumatized for their own life. I get it. I agree with you, though.
I'm a soldier.
Yeah.
You know I am.
Absolutely. If you thought Stephanie wasn't going to give it to you straight, how you feel about Juneteenth? You think Stephanie will be in the White House singing?
No. No. That I am not impressed. Not impressed. And, you know, I'm happy that we have Joe Biden, because I think that he's a sensitive and more compassionate president than, mm-hmm, than the fool we had before. But, and I love Pamela, you know, black women, we rock together. Mm-hmm. But I just think it's like a slap in the face. Our children are suffering in school. They need their money. I don't know what they're doing with all this money for the school system and putting money back into our community.
How did the pandemic affect you and your family?
You know, it really didn't. I mean, we stayed in the house and all of that. But in the beginning, mm-hmm, I was terrorized. I didn't
really
know what was going on. I was like, what is going on in this country? But then, you know, I have crazy faith. And I just rolled with it. I took each day. Mm-hmm. And I took each day. And I lived such I don't live a fancy life. So I wasn't hurt financially or anything. And even though it was a year and a half that I didn't work. But me and my son, we just chilled and took each day.
Didn't it feel good to have a backyard? Can you imagine having to live in New York doing that?
Lord, it felt good to have a backyard, to go out and sit on my front porch and just be okay. Mm-hmm. You know, because you don't know. We weren't prepared for it.
Not at all.
But you just don't know. But I just rolled with it. I rolled with the punches.
Yeah, you look like a 27-year-old.
How is our baby Farad?
He's here. He's out there.
He's out.
He,
I go nowhere without my son because I don't trust nobody. And I don't
want to
kill nobody.
That's right.
Over my son. So,
so,
I take him with me.
Now, you look 20-something, right?
I'm grown.
So, have you ever seen a time like this? From last year to even, have you ever seen anything like this in your existence?
Never.
Wow.
Never in my life. And my mom, who's my hero, was an activist even though she didn't know it. And even though we went through the Rodney King thing, mm-hmm. and the fires in Los Angeles, I was living in Los Angeles at that time. But I've never seen anything like this. I've
wow.
never seen Republicans, even though we know that they were what they were, it's just coming out. It's so natural for them to tear us down. But when we fight back or say something about them, then we're being, you know, racist, mm-hmm. and that's not true.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like what Kevin Hart is going through with that man.
Bill Maher?
Yeah. Mm-hmm. You know, how can he say things are better? No, they're not. They're worse. They really want to put us back in slavery. I mean, it's, I guess that's why they want to make Juneteenth a natural habit. But are we really free?
No.
No.
No,
no,
no. No. Never, never happened.
No.
Yeah. I mean, all the promises of this country, the freedom, the liberty, the justice for all has been a lie.
Right.
It's never been for us. Absolutely.
No. Now, Stephanie, now that you have this new single out and you're back in the studio, what else is coming? Because I could tell this might feel like even more what's going on.
The next song is called We Must Change.
You did two?
I did eight.
Eight? Okay.
Okay.
Well, Marcus inspired me, and we just went in there, and just, I got four more, we call them my babies, so I'm pregnant with four more songs, and then I'm going to deliver them in a minute. In fact, I'm going to record that in Nashville, in Memphis, where Al Green recorded most of his stuff, and we're going to do it live. All my music is live, drums, live piano, everything is live, no synth or whatever the shit they use.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know.
So you're going to do a whole new album?
No, I'm just going to release singles.
Okay, okay.
As I feel it, I'm going to release, you know, singles. But I'm getting them ready.
And you're back on the road, right?
Yeah, I'm back on the road. I got to make up for shows that we did, that we didn't do the year and a half. And then there's people that are calling. So I'm back on the road. In fact, I'll be here at NJ Pack, Atlantic City, Brooklyn. I'm doing... the thing with DJ D Nice in September in Brooklyn.
Mm-hmm.
We're gonna have people out there. So yeah.
Are you ready to get back to doing live shows?
I love doing live shows more than I did recording, because the producer thing with the recordings, I don't like working with producers that just do beats. Because
mm-hmm.
I'm not that kind of artist.
Mm-hmm.
I sing live, I want live music. So
live shows is something that's essential to you, because that's another thing, right? During the pandemic, we all realized what's essential.
Yes.
To us.
What's important.
What's important. So
yes.
What's some of the things you cut off because you realize, like, yeah, it's really not that important?
A lot of people that were toxic.
Mm.
I cut off a lot of toxic, you know, people. Simplicity was getting up in the morning and just having my coffee and watching Good Morning America. Was like, you know,
mm-hmm.
and just simple things. Just, it's not that deep.
Mm-hmm.
It's not that deep.